These days, if you're suffering from shoddy mobile reception, there's a number of ways you can get around that by using Wi-Fi to boost your mobile signal. Got no signal at the back of your favourite coffee shop? Take the call on Wi-Fi. Stuck underground and need to ring your Tinder date? Take the call on Wi-Fi. Haven't paid the phone bill because you needed to feed your family? Take the call on Wi-Fi. Like we said, there's a number of apps out there that let you use Wi-Fi as a miniature mobile mast. But which one's the best? Popular Facebook-owned instant messenger WhatsApp recently added a voice calling service for iOS, Android and BlackBerry 10 devices. WhatsApp scans your contacts book and lets you make calls with people even if you don't have their mobile number, which is really handy. This of course depends on whether or not they actually use the app themselves. If you don't have or can't get WhatsApp for whatever reason, there's always Facebook Messenger. If you use Facebook on your phone, chances are you've probably already got this installed. The downside is, this only lets you call people you know on Facebook. While that's handy if you don't happen to know their number, it's less handy if they've blocked you or they still haven't accepted your friend request. I mean, what the f***, Lana Del Rey? Add me already. I'm not weird. Another downside of Facebook Messenger is that you can't currently call people from the Windows Phone version of the app. So if you've got mates with Lumia phones, you won't be able to reach them this way. Luckily for Windows Phone users, the Skype app does support voice calls over Wi-Fi, as you may well expect. This means you can chat away with folks for free, more or less regardless of whatever phone they're using. Skype works on iOS, Android, Windows Phone, BlackBerry 10, Amazon Fire phones, and even Nokia X phones, which are used by nobody. That's all well and good, but what about those times for when you want to call somebody on a landline? Depending on who you get your broadband service from, you could make use of a service like Virgin Media's SmartCall or TalkTalk's Talk2Go, which we just so happen to have done a hands-on review of, which you can watch here. These services not only let you use Wi-Fi to make calls, they also let you soak up any unused landline minutes that are part of your home phone plan. If you don't have Virgin or TalkTalk broadband, then you can make use of similar apps like 3's InTouch or O2To Go. Although, obviously, these apps are only available if you're a 3 or an O2 customer, so bear that in mind. EE has already made Wi-Fi calling a standard feature of its high-end phones, so devices like the Samsung Galaxy S6 come with Wi-Fi calling built in. The second you're connected to Wi-Fi, it will automatically route calls over that connection instead of the regular network. While this gives you a coverage boost, you'll still be charged as you normally would. So if you've got a 500-minute month allowance, for example, the calls will come out of that. Of course, if you're a cheapskate like me, then you'll still be able to make use of things like Skype and WhatsApp to make free calls if you don't fancy using up those minutes. So that's Wi-Fi calling. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And now you're going to have to excuse me because I've got to take a Wi-Fi call from Lana Del Rey's lawyer. Okay. Hello? Yep. What do you mean restraining order?